Gerald, another video on barcode scanning? Yes, because I like options. So in this video, we're going to look at a last option for now to scan barcodes in your dotnet MAUI app. In an earlier video, I showed you Camera.MAUI, which is a plugin that allows you to have a camera view inside of your dotnet MAUI application. But besides taking snapshots, taking pictures, it can also scan barcodes, also based on ZXing or zebra crossing, just like the ZXing MAUI plugin that there already is. But this one implements that as well. So, you know, I like options. You can have options. So let's look at how to implement that with this specific plugin, because it's very, very easy. If you haven't watched the other video, I highly recommend that you do that first, because there I will talk about how to install the plugin, how to initialize it and do all that stuff. This is just focusing on scanning the actual barcode. So I'm going to hop over to my screen share right here and show you how to get started with that. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I already set up a new dotnet MAUI project. I already arranged some couple of things. Like I already mentioned in the previous video, I went over to how to implement this camera view. So that's kind of like where we're leaving off. If I just run this application real quick, then you will see that we have the little camera view with which you can take pictures if that's what you want, but we can show the camera. So our application is coming up here and we should see this little live view of the camera preview right here. So you will get a little backstage thing here. Let me just get myself out of the way. You can see it asks for the permissions, let's say while using the app, and you can say that I have these this camera preview, right? So you can do all these things. Okay, so with that in place, we can now implement the barcode scanning, which is also available out of the box. Before we go into that, let me show you quickly the steps that I took here. So in your Solution Explorer, right click on your project, do Manage NuGet Packages, and here you will install the Camera.MAUI plugin. You can see it right here. 1.2.1 is the version at the time of recording, so install that, go check out the repository, leave a star on that if you like this project. Then in your MAUI program, make sure that you have this use MAUI camera view right here. So add that. You will need this using camera.MAUI. This will initialize the plugin and you will have that. And of course, then you need to add the permissions for the actual camera in your each for the platforms folder, right? So here we have on Android, the Android manifest file. If I open that with the XML editor, then you can see that I added the camera right here. For iOS, Mac Catalyst, for Windows, you need to add this to your metadata so that the permission will come up, the permission request for the user that we've just seen to ask for usage of the camera. So now to implement the barcode scanning. Basically, everything is set up for this already. There is two things that you need to do to get the basic setup going. So you can say barcode scanning, barcode detection enabled is true. That seems important. So we have that. You can set it to true or false depending on what you need. And then we have this event for barcode detected. Now, if you want to use this with MVVM as well, then you can bind to this barcode results, which is a bindable property. And whenever new results come in, that property will be updated. So you can catch that in a MVVM way. If that's something that you're interested in, I'm not going to show it right now, but if you can figure it out, let me know down in the comments. I'll answer you, or I'll make a little new video about it. I'm going to use it with the barcode detected, and you can see there's a couple of more options, right? So you can set the frame rate, you can set more barcode options. We'll look into that a little bit more. So there's a couple of things that you can do here, but I'm going to implement this barcode detected, which is an event. So this generates a new event here in the code behind, and you can see here already the code for like the camera view, right? So I finished setting that up here, implementing it in XAML, and here you have to do the cameras loaded. You have to check out the previous video also why this weird workaround is in here. Someone left in the comments, by the way, that you could should also be able to do task.delay 500, and that you could fix the start camera with this as well. The stop and start works for me, so I'm just going to leave it like this, but with a little task delay, it should be able to work when the camera doesn't start right away as well. So little tip right here. But we're focusing on the barcode, so we have the barcodes right here, and whenever this happens, so a barcode is detected inside of your view, we have to do something with the main thread, at least if you want to update the UI. So I could easily do a console write line right here and just do that in the console output. But let's make it a little bit more visible. And I'm going to add a little label here on the top, label with a name so that I can reference it, barcode result. And let's make the font size 20 so that you can see it. And okay, so we have that, a label that we can use. But if you want to update something in the UI, the barcode scanning happens on a background thread. So you want to make sure that you're doing it on the main thread so that the UI actually gets updated. So we have helpers for that in .NET MAUI already. We can do main thread dot begin invoke on main thread. And here we can do then label, barcode result dot text is, and then we have the args here. So the arguments that are coming in, the barcode event args dot result. And this is an array of multiple results. You can scan multiple results in one go. That's one of the options. But I'm just going to assume there's always one dot text. And you have like other things, right? You have the points, you have the barcode format, so it will detect what kind of format it is. Actually, let's put that in there here as well. I'm going to do a little string interpolation here. So we're going to say args barcode format, and then semicolon, and then I'm going to say the actual barcode args dot result. Oh, forgot the curly braces. Args dot result dot zero dot text. Right, so I get the actual text result from that thing as well. So we will get the barcode format that it detected, and then the actual text in here. So we got that, and then I need to close this. Device begin invoke on main thread. So we have that. So now it's going to run in the main thread and it's going to update my text whenever it detects a barcode. So let's just quickly check that out. I'm going to run this. So I don't think I mentioned it, but this is my physical device that is mirrored here on the right side of your screen. I have this right here because testing these things with a physical camera typically just works best because you have an actual camera right here. So we have our camera here. No need for the permission because I already did that. I have this random barcode lying around here. So if I bring that in the camera, then you will see it picks up on code 39 and it gives the actual value. And you can see it's correct because it's printed down below there. So we've got that. And I got this barcode, this QR code actually here on the other monitor. So really behind the scenes footage here. And if I go to that, you can see that it should pick up on that as well. And it said, well, QR code, don't forget to like and subscribe. Well, isn't that convenient? Maybe there is something that you want to like and subscribe. Please do it now. I would very much appreciate it. So you can see QR codes, regular barcodes, it just scans it and it scans it pretty quickly, right? So that's pretty cool. And it just does that out of the box. Now, I promise you there would be multiple options. So you can set also some camera view options with the barcode options. So if I go to camera view, which is the field that I have here for the camera view, right? So I have this camera view, which is named camera view. And I'm going to get into that. And I say barcode options, which is a object of the type barcode options, probably barcode decode option. So I'm going to create a new one for that. And with this, I can customize the options for the barcode scanning. So it has a bunch of properties, auto rotate, so it will try to rotate the QR code that if I'm doing this in landscape or whatnot, it's going to auto rotate it to better detect the barcode in here. The character set you can do with that, possible format. So if you just want to scan only QR codes, you can go to ZXing barcode format. And here you can also see all the formats that are supported. So Aztec, code 39. I don't even know what half of these are, but you can say if you only want to have QR codes, just say, hey, I just want to have QR codes, or maybe only the ones that we just saw. So QR code and code 39, I think. Now it will only scan these two, right? So the rest will be ignored. It will only scan these two. What else do we got? Pure barcode. To be honest, I'm not even sure what that means. So go look that up in the ZXing documentation. Read multiple barcodes. So can it read more from kind of one frame? Try harder, which is always a funny property. Like, hey, should it try harder? I don't know what it does behind the scene, but it will try harder to detect the barcode. And try inverted. It tries to invert the colors for if you have maybe funky colored barcodes or anything like that. So that's all options that you can work with, but you don't necessarily have to, because you can see just hooking up that event and setting it to true makes it scanning already. So that is pretty awesome. And that's how easy it is to get started with this barcode scanning with the Camera.MAUI plugin. Another option, another great option to scan barcodes with your .NET MAUI app. I already made a couple of videos about other ones. The one is already based on ZXing as well. The other one is based on Google Vision ML Kit. So I will post the links down below in the video description and the comments. So make sure to check those out if barcodes are something that you are very interested in. But I think this is a great option. It seems a little bit more performant than the other ZXing plugin. I don't know. It runs on the same background. And also I see some people mention like, hey, the other, the more well-known ZXing plugin can't code QR codes on certain devices. On my device, the Samsung one, it seems to scan fine, but if you have any problems, please let me know down in the comments below. Like I said, look up the repository for this plugin, star it, and of course, while you're starring and liking things anyway, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and I'll be seeing you for my next video, maybe one from this playlist right here with all kinds of .NET MAUI videos, or this highly recommended video just for you. See you on the other side.